move. I gotta be out of my house at the end of the month, so before they break, you don't just waste that.
Yeah, well, you can eat pie and move. There's always time for
pie. Both at the same time.
It's doable.
That way you got the shop and everything?
What's it?
You got the shop.
Yeah.
And then
you can shop and eat pie. House? You can pee and eat pie.
So you've been in the shop?
Essentially for now, yes. The all the furniture is going into the shop until we get it into the house. So.
Temporary staging ground until
It's like the janitor was eating pie while they were cleaning the whiteboard.
I hate moving shit. And I seem to never stop doing it.
Have you got to the part where you're like, how did I get so much shit?
Oh, yeah. No, I get to that part every time I move.
Dude, it's like, where
and
did
when
this
I moved out here, I took as little stuff as I could, and it's still an awful lot of stuff.
Oh, yeah. It's
we've insane. We've got the brunt of it done. I actually have more shop than I do house. No. So it's, what do I need furniture, you know?
Don't need so.
Who needs two couches?
I really don't. Yeah.
Just sitting one at a time.
I just need a lawn chair.
When I live, when I lived in Georgia, I had one chair. You know, I've had that chair since 1996. It's a great chair. I had to kick an old guy out of it when I bought it. So it's.
He was flying.
I bought it at a junk shop.
He was probably homeless too. He was like, give me that.
It's a great chair. Oh. All right. Let's see. So I think we're done with count two for the most part. So what we got left is review for the final, because that's coming up. It's what, December the 9th?
Uh-huh.
It's on a Saturday.
Nice.
Yeah, just because it's not good enough that we blow your Friday nights during the semester, right? It's all right. It's ruined two of my weeks.
That's the first semester, so. That's the first day of final.
I think so. Yeah. Nice. So, well, we can get it over with. You know, tear that Band-Aid off right away. And, that's something to be said for that. So, all right, get that away. And that also means we can get the grading done in some reasonable amount of time. So, I figure the exam's probably going to be divided roughly into thirds as far as coverage. You know, it'll have some stuff from each section. It'll have sequences of series. It'll have Taylor series. It'll have integration techniques, all that stuff. So, it is a cumulative exam. We haven't been tested over the last third of it, so but there's less of it, you know, so it ends up being weighted about equally in each category.
Okay.
So I haven't been emailed any old exams as of yet, but I'm sure we'll get them. I think we're a little ahead of schedule compared to the other classes, but we can at least talk about some of the stuff that we covered at the beginning of the semester and make sure we're on top of that. As far as what you're weakest on, do you want to work on a particular section today? Between integration techniques, Taylor series, geometric stuff, what do you think?
Yeah, everything.
Everything, yeah. That's not exactly what I had in mind with the word focus, but... Sorry.
I guess we didn't really hit that approximation stuff.
Yeah, the Taylor series stuff. Yeah.
Since that's, we kind of skimmed right over that.
I know that's going to be on there with the Taylor series approximations, the mirror terms, that kind of thing. Okay, so let's talk about that first, I guess.
I think it was secret series. And I checked the I should be sure.
Okay. So... approximations and error terms. All right, so suppose I want to use the Taylor series. Centered at something, we'll figure that out in a minute. Approximate. All right, let me think about this. Yeah.
approximate 1/10. Let's see if we can figure out how to do that. So, all right. Let's use a Taylor series to set it at x equal to 9. And I guess let's use a Taylor polynomial. And let's say degree 3 to approximate 1/10. So what are we looking at anyway? I'm looking at, I want centered at x equals 9. So f of x is 1/√x. All right. Okay, and I'm going to represent this as c0 plus c1 times x minus 9 plus c2 times x minus 9 squared plus c3 times x minus 9 cubed, right? So that's what your Taylor polynomials look like. The reason I'm using 9 here is because square root of 9 is something that I can take,
right?
That's something we can calculate. So how do you get a Taylor polynomial? How do you get your coefficients?
Take the derivative?
Yeah, we're going to need three derivatives, right? So, f prime of x. Now, f of x is what? X to the -1/2? Okay, so f prime of x is -1/2 times x to the -3/2. F double prime is -1/2 times -3/2 times x to the -5/2. F triple prime is -1/2 times -3/2 times -5/2 times x to the -7/2. Okay. Now what we need is, what is f of 9, f prime of 9, f double prime of 9, and so on. Because that's how we're going to get our coefficients, right? Okay. F of 9 is 9 to the -1/2, which is what? 1/√9 is 1/3. Okay. F prime of 9 is, it looks like two negatives are going to cancel, and I got 3/4 times 9 to the -5/2. So let's write that out as a fraction.
Where is the second negative from?
This one?
In f prime. Right.
So, oh, f prime should be negative, shouldn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, yeah. All right.
Hold on.
Oh, yeah, I'm off by a thing here. Okay, I got you. All right, so f prime, I'm looking at the line below it. F prime is -1/2 times 9 to the -3/2, which is -1/2 times 1/9 times 1/3, right? Okay, so this is -1/54. F double prime, this is the one that is 3/4 times 9 to the -5/2. So this is 3/4 times 1/81 times 1/3, is that right? Because it's a 2.5 power on the bottom. Threes cancel. And I get 1/324, is that what you're getting? Okay. Then f triple prime, looks like I've got -15/8 times 9 to the -7/2. All right. So it's going to be -15/8 times 1/9³. 729, and then also times 1/3 because that's the extra 1/2 power. That cancels out some, and I got -5/729 times 8, which is 5832. Okay. All right. So what is this coming from? Now,
That means I know my Taylor polynomial is f of x equals c0, which is f of 9, so it's 1/3, plus, how do I get c1? It's just minus f prime of 9, so 1 over 54 times x minus 9, plus c2 is going to be f double prime over 2.
Times 3 times 4.
So what is that? 1 over 648, is that right? Mm-hmm. Times x minus 9 squared, and then minus, it'll be this over 3 factorial, which is 6, right? So 5832 times 6. All right, so this will be 5 over 34992 times x minus 9 cubed. Okay. So if I wanted to approximate the square root of 10, what would I do with this particular formula? I would evaluate this at 10, right? So it'd be 1/3 minus 1/54 of 10 minus 9 plus 1 over 648 of 10 minus 9 squared minus 5 over 34992 times 10 minus 9 cubed. So all your 10 minus 9s are just going to be 1. So it's just an alternating sum of these fractions. Mm-hmm. I don't really want to do the third grade arithmetic here, so I'm going to let Wolfram do it.
Good old Wolfram. Ran it home.
What I've got is 1/3 minus 1 over 54 plus 1 over 648 minus 5 over 34992 Okay, so far this is coming out to 11065 over 34992. So there's a fractional approximation of the square root of 10 using this thing. And I'm actually kind of curious what this comes out to as a float value. It's like 0.31 something or other. Does that sound right?
Yeah, sure.
Now how am I going to square a number that's less than 1 and get 10? Oh, wait a minute.
It's 1 over.
I was looking at 1 over square root of 10. All right. So remember 0.3162. 1 over square root of 10 is about 0.3162. So it did give us a reasonable approximation of this thing by a fraction. So the question is, what's our error term look like, right? So that's how you would get the actual approximation. And of course, in a testing situation, you're not going to have fractions like 1 over 34992 that you have to add to anything. But we might give you something that's on this order that's just simpler numbers. So let's take a look at what the error term looks like from Taylor's theorem. Now, error term in Pn of x from Taylor's theorem looks like you'll have your n plus first derivative evaluated somewhere times x minus the center of the series to the n plus 1 over n plus 1 factorial, right? So the key is in the error term, where you evaluate the derivative is not at the center. It's someplace in between the center and x. Okay, so here, what am I looking at? Now this is Rm of x. Now we went out to the third derivative, right? So this should be the fourth derivative evaluated at somewhere times 10 minus 9 to the fourth power. Now hold on. Yeah. Because it looks just like the first term that you left off. All right, this is going to be over 4 factorial. Now, the question is, what does the fourth derivative look like anyway? 10 minus 9 to the fourth is just 1, so that's no big deal. So this looks like fourth derivative of f evaluated somewhere over 4 factorial. All right, now, this is going to be in the interval from 9 to 10 because we're somewhere in between the center of the series and the place we're evaluating the function. So, all right. Let's see. F4 of x. All right. Now, we started out with x to the negative 1 half. So, we're going to have what? Negative 1 half times negative 3 halves times negative 5 halves times negative 7 halves times x to the negative 9 halves. Isn't that what your derivative looks like? Okay. And so the question is, what are some bounds on this when x is between 9 and 10? So, first of all, this is a positive function, and usually we want the absolute value of this thing anyway. What is this? 16 on the bottom. I don't know what 3 times 5 times 7 is. We'll figure it out. So I've got 105 over 16 times something to the negative 9 halves. All right. And I need to figure out what's the biggest this can be when the place I'm evaluating it is somewhere between 9 and 10. Okay. First question. Is this an increasing function or a decreasing function of x? I think it's decreasing, because if I take the derivative, you notice I'm going to get negatives, right? I'm going to get an odd number negative, so it'll be negative, right? So this is a decreasing function. So if I want the maximum value of it, and that's supposed to be a 10, I'm sorry. Yeah. You're well within your rights, yeah. That was nonsense. Okay, so, all right, so the point is, if this is a decreasing function, in between 9 and 10, looks like that, right? Okay, so if I want to get a bound on the biggest this can be, where do I want to evaluate it? I want to evaluate it at 9, right? So the capital M that people were struggling with in these things is the biggest value that your derivative can take on. So we know that F4 of x, in this case, it's going to be less than or equal to f4 of 9 whenever x is in between 9 and 10. Because the fourth derivative of f is a decreasing function between 9 and 10. So in other words, our capital M is going to be fourth derivative evaluated at 9. You see where that's coming from? All right, so what is that anyway? This will be capital M, looks like it is 105 over 16 times 9 to the negative 9 halves. 105 over 16 times 1 over 9 over 2 is what, 4 and a half? I don't know what 9 to the 4th is, but let's look. $65.61. then also times 3, right? Because that's 4.5 powers of 9. All right, I think 3 goes into 105, because you get 35 on top. So this is 35 over 65, 61 times 16 is 104,976. So there's your capital M that's going to work for that. All right. So in other words, my error is less than or equal to capital M over 4 factorial. So I need to divide this number by 24. All right. That's going to be 35 over this number by 24, 2,519,424. Okay, so that's a relatively small error, right? Mm-hmm. So let me get a decimal approximation to this thing. So 1 over x. Times 35. Okay. Now this is 0.00001389 something. Okay. So what I'm interested in is this is a bound on how big our error could be, right? How big was our error actually?
Hello. Stick our key.
Okay, our actual error is, well, it's 1 over the square root of 10 minus, what was that fraction that we came up with? Somebody write that down.
11,665
divided by 34,992.
She's all on it.
All right, say that again very slowly.
992.
92? Mm-hmm. So is this
right? And it was 11,065.
65. 11065.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So let's take a look at that. See what our actual error is.
Shalom. Shalom.
11065 over.